Hi, this is a spiritual crystal card reading for the month of March for Capricorn. So let's see, what is your main energy? What is your main energy for March? And this is Celestine. So Celestine actually is the crystal who connects you with the angelic realms. So it connects you to a higher consciousness. So it helps you actually to connect with a higher consciousness. It also, what it also does is, of course, say helping you when you go through difficult, sad times. So when there are times when you are emotionally feeling sad, it's not really depressed, but it's like, oh my God, it's not really, you know, it's not really this. It's not a happy feeling. It's not like you're on top of it. It's a little bit the opposite. And so Celestine can help you with this, you know, can help you to make you realize that there's a bigger picture. And not only the picture that you see or that you feel, it's a bigger thing is going on there. So that you connect through this bigger, to these higher energies, for to take the power from there, for to make it happen during your daily life here. So let's see, what is your helping, okay? What is your helping card or helping stone? And this is Ruby. So Ruby actually says, open your heart, because it's because of the difficulties of the daily life that you actually have closed your heart again. So it's time to open it again, you know, it's time to open it and to do whatever you do with love. So to be fully involved in what you're doing, you know, with your whole being, with passion, with love, with care. And this will help you to go through the times you are a little bit more difficult. Let's see first week. First week for you for March. And this is tourmaline. So green tourmaline. So that means if you follow these instructions, if I can say it like this, of opening your heart and be connected with the higher self, with the higher picture, with higher realms, to be connected, you will see that it leads you actually to the heart level where you can let go of what is bothering you, and you will feel actually good. That means it will help you to go out of this kind of low feeling. So this is the green tourmaline. You can wear a green tourmaline or a ruby this month. So let's see what's for the second week. Second week is amber, what is really good. Because amber is also very protective. So amber gives you the feeling. Sometimes it is like, you know, when we have this low feeling, it can be sometimes just because we have a low energy for the moment. So our chakra, not our chakra, our aura is like weakened because of the low energy. Everything is energy anyway. Everything is one. So when we wear this amber, it is like it reinforces our field around us, our energy field, so that we feel more protected and more secure inside. So this is amber. So it also gives you a feeling of abundance, a feeling of nurturing, you know, the self, the inner feeling of nurturing, a little bit of feeling of the baby inside who is nurtured by the mother, nurtured in the womb, you know, this protective feeling. This is for the second week. So if you are missing this, wear an amber, it will help you. So, but going a little bit more into the second week, it's because you will feel this, it is all is connected actually with here, with your helping energy. Because the main energy is this lower energy. I won't say depression because it's not really depression, but it is not really seeing a future either. It's so balancing in between those two, you know, it's like feeling low. So wear a ruby, or you can, for example, also make an elixir of ruby. You know, you can take it and it will help you to go through it. But the main thing is, if you do this, then you will see through the first week already, you will feel this week exactly, you will feel an amelioration, because you will be able to let go. And on the second week, actually, you will start to feel that the inner energy, this protection shield that you feel the inside, you will start to spread it out. So that means that in your aura, actually, you will have a larger space where you will feel comfortable. And you will start to be able, again, to feel better and to move also. within to this space of feeling, of feeling good, of feeling protected. So if you need the lady, if you need more protection, you wear an amber. So let's see for the third week. Third week for Capricorn for March, and here you have the rose quartz. So you see, you're going through a process of healing of the heart. You're going through a process of release, of relax. It's like this main feeling that you have of not moving on, of not going forwards. Actually, it's going because you're working on it. So you don't stay and sit in this low energy. So you fight. You fight against it, you work with it, you acknowledge it, and you let it go. That's what's happening. So if you do this, you come onto the third week, onto rose quartz, where in that week, your heart already has been healing or is in the position of healing. But you already have moved out of the sadness of the main energy that is the starter of the month, actually. So let's see what's for the fourth week. Fourth week here you have calcite. So calcite means, first of all, reconnect with joy. Okay, it's the inner joy that is missing. The inner joy is missing. It is like you don't know what to do, you don't know where to go, you don't know which decision to take. That's a little bit the main energy. Joy is missing. That's why you get stuck. That's why you feel like, what now? What am I doing now? Where am I now? What is the next step, you know? Calcite at the end of the cycle here of the month is actually saying it's all in your head. Everything anyway is all in your head, but it is like saying change your thoughts. Change your thoughts and concentrate on being spontaneous and joy. So bring joy in your daily life. This is a little bit the antidote for the energy where you actually a little bit trapped in, I would say. You know, the antidote is joy, it's spontaneous, do things that you like to do, and at the same time it is also open your heart and let things flow instead of blocking it off because you don't feel good. Because that's what we are doing. We don't feel good, oop, we close our heart, and it's connected. Our heart is closed, we don't feel good, and it is like they are always, it's like an a little going around, you know, it's like one is not without the other, and it's just going around. So what we have to do is actually to stop being into this energy that actually brings us down, and to open, even if we don't feel like, because we have closed our heart, that's actually also why we are feeling like this, is through meditation with crystals, or wear crystals, or bug flowers, whatever you like, what is good for you, to reopen the heart chakra. And so to be back into the stream of abundance of love. And so reconnect then with your third chakra, what is joy and being spontaneous, so that you can bring the energy up, so that you start to be joyful like a child. A child never thinks what it's going to do next, you know, it's just, aha, woohoo, jump and go for the next thing, what is nice and what is beautiful, or what is bringing joy, what it likes to do. So reconnect with the child within. And see what you can, what comes up. What do you want to do? And this will help you. So let's see what is the message from the angels. The message of the angels is purpurine. Purpurine is very, of course, very spiritual. But it is also like saying there are new things for you. You know, it's like a cycle. There is something new, but you still haven't acknowledge it, or you are not aware of it. It can also be that it is good for you for the moment to talk to somebody who has knowledge, with whom you can talk, with whom you can help, who can help you or just ask advice. So for the rest, have a look a little bit into another direction. Maybe you have taken a direction, you have taken a choice, and this is not really fitting. So have a look through what else can you do. Have a look what else can you do, what else is there for you, if there are more things. And maybe it's necessary for you to ask advice as well, to ask advice to certain people. Let's see another one. Let's see what else can be there, and this is beautiful. This is the sun stone. So the sun stone is again also the third chakra. It's again, it reconnects again with joy. Find your joy within again. Find your joy within. It can be, maybe you ask some advice, or you look for new projects, new things to do. Concentrate on the heart. You can drink also the elixir of rose quartz. It will help you to soften the whole feeling. You can wear amber for protection. And of course, ruby or green tourmaline is very strong as well for the heart. So, thank you for watching. And of course, if you would like a personal spiritual crystal card reading, you can contact me through my website. And otherwise, I wish you a lovely month. Enjoy it and reconnect with the child within. Bye-bye.